military more capable, and now more lethal, more fearless, and more skilled than the United States Armed Forces. You are the warriors who defend our freedom. You are the patriots who ensure the flame of liberty burns forever bright. That's who you are. That's who you are.
Well, after initial inaccurate criticism that the president was not going to visit the troops overseas, it seems some in the media still are not satisfied. They're blasting the president's first trip to a combat zone for everything he did wrong while there.
He's like the Grinch. Instead of, I'm being honest.
No, he stole Christmas.
Instead of being positive with the troops, saying this is about the troops, it's not about me. You want positivity when it comes to Christmas. It is perplexing. Why would he visit the troops and do that?
Look, I think it's important that the president goes and visits the troops, but he's doing this backwards.
Right, it is, in fact, a campaign slogan. That is a campaign item, and it's completely inappropriate for the troops to do
this. Not supposed to do it.
But look, the president has to take some ownership of this, too. Every time he's around military audiences, he tends to politicize it, and he brings in complaints and grievances from outside the realm of military policy.
Well, as you can imagine, a few moments ago, the president decided to fire back, tweeting, CNN and others within the fake news universe were going wild about my signing MAGA hats for our military in Iraq and Germany. If these brave young people ask me to sign their hat, I'll sign. Can you imagine me saying no? We brought or gave no hats, as the fake news first reported. He was referring to how some suggested perhaps he brought the hats. Amber Smith is a former Army pilot and Pentagon official, now a senior fellow at the Independent Women's Forum. And Marie Harf, of course, is a former State Department and CIA spokesperson, now a Fox News analyst. Good evening, ladies.
Hello, Ed.
Good evening.
Amber, the president was being criticized for not going, then he goes, and all of a sudden, he's the Grinch.
I think this is a new low for media personalities and a news network to go after U.S. troops who are fighting in a combat zone right now with the sole purpose of hurting President Trump. When I first heard this news breaking, I said, this is absolutely fantastic. Republicans, Democrats, Americans, we can all get behind this because there is literally nothing negative about the commander-in-chief going to visit troops who are in harm's way. And so this is real life for them. Every single day, they're going out on missions that are extremely dangerous. Mm-hmm. So they're not sitting there behind a desk in Washington, D.C., researching the latest on political policy out of the Department of Defense. They're wondering if they're going to make it home tonight and if their buddy is going to, too. So I think this criticism is absolutely ludicrous, and they just want to criticize the president to criticize him. Yep. President Trump could cure cancer, and they would still find something negative about it.
I've heard that one before, and you might be right after this latest criticism, because Marie, even USA Today wrote an editorial. They were fair, and they said, look, for Trump to take time away from his own holiday at home to visit with combat deployed troops reminds them America has not forgotten. Politics aside, what's important is a simple fact that he showed up. Why is that not good enough?
Well, I think it's a good thing that the president went to visit the troops. Finally, he should have done it sooner. But I think it's a good thing, Ed, and I think he gets credit for that. And some of the criticism goes too far. But I will say on two points, it is absolutely fair to criticize the president. He told lies, basically. I'll just say it. He said things that were not true to the troops about the fact that he said he was the first president to give them a pay raise in several years. That is not true. He said he gave them a pay raise of 10%. That is also not true. It is absolutely fair to criticize that. He also did, as you heard John Kirby say on another network, and let me tell you, I know John Kirby, he is not a liberal Democrat. He's probably not even a Democrat, as far as I know. He said that the president bringing in issues that are domestic political issues like the wall, going after Nancy Pelosi, that substance is not appropriate, and that is fair to criticize.
Okay.
I think that's,
I wanna talk to you. I think you make a fair point about the pay raise. I'm not quite sure why the president keeps repeating that. But you're making the case now that this was about politics and somehow it was wrong for the president to inject politics. Here's one of your former bosses, President Barack Obama. I wanted to play this clip. December 6th, 2016, talking to the troops. By the way, that's the picture of him signing autographs in 2008 that I mentioned earlier. So he signed autographs as well, whether it's right or wrong. Both sides have done it. Barack Obama was trying to be nice to the troops. So was President Trump. I'm not sure why that criticism. But then on your point about politicizing things with the troops, here's what Barack Obama said to the troops.
The United States of America is not a country that imposes religious tests as a price for freedom. The United States of America is not a place where some citizens have to withstand greater scrutiny or carry a special ID card or prove that they're not an enemy from within. We're a country that has bled and struggled and sacrificed against that kind of discrimination and arbitrary rule. In other words, we are a nation that at our best has been defined by hope and not fear.
Marie, he said this in December after Donald Trump had been elected. Never used his name. You and I both know he was going after Donald Trump.
But I would say the president, President Obama, was very careful not to go after specific political opponents or political members of the other party. He did not use their names. He was talking about ideals.
Well, he didn't use his name, but he said we can't have a religious test. Pardon me. He's talking about the Muslim ban. You and I know that. He's attacking Donald Trump.
Look, he was talking about ideals that he believes are important to all Americans, okay? Donald Trump went to a military base and started talking about Nancy Pelosi and the shutdown and Democrats being responsible and told things to the troops that were not true about their pay raises. I don't care if he signs hats.
Ed,
I don't care if he signs hats.
Okay.
I don't care if he signs hats, but there is a fundamental difference between what he did and what Barack Obama did in that clip you just played.
Go ahead, Amber, you've been patient.
The clip that you just showed, Ed, just shows the hypocritical nature of the media when it comes to the president. Let me tell you what matters to those troops who are on the ground in Iraq, some of who have been in Syria and who are back in Iraq now. They care about their commander-in-chief who came to visit them. And you want to know why? Because him visiting them in country, in the war zone, says that they matter, that they are recognized, and they are remembered by the American people. And so that's what they're going to take away from this, that the commander-in-chief took time out of his holiday schedule and came over into a combat zone to see them. That is what matters.
Okay.
And so when people are away from their families during the holidays, that's what they're going to remember, not a side comment about politics.
Marie, I press you on that with the tape. I want to give you the last word. I got less than a minute, but I want to be fair and give you the last word.
I am glad the president went to visit the troops. I think that going into the new year, we as a country need to take a hard look at what our policy is in Syria, what it is in Iraq, who the next Secretary of Defense is going to be. These are bigger questions than political fights over a visit to troops, which I think he was right to do. And I hope that the National Security Team is having those discussions right now, because these are really important decisions we have to get right.
At that point, we can all agree, some major national security decisions ahead in 2019. Marie, Amber, thanks for both coming in. Happy New Year.
Thanks, Ed.
Happy New Year, Ed.
All right.